All right, good morning. Since the passage of the Rail Safety Act in 2008, SEPTA has been working hard to meet the positive train control deadline of 12/31/15. But what you need to understand is that automatic train control and access equals positive train control or a compliance system. This is SEPTA's PTC Frazer test track. We've had it up and operating for a while. It basically shows that we have a proof of concept. Our very capable engineer is Steve Finnegan. He's been an engineer for 38 years. Our approach to PTC is working, and we're taking a train out of the yard now and towards the line to be able to show and simulate a couple situations that show how PTC works to enforce greater safety on our vehicles. Just around the curve up ahead are two devices in the track area. They're basically square devices called transponders. And that's what's utilized to turn on the system. We have a reader underneath the train, and it will pick up the transponders. And now if you go to the aspect display unit, you can see that PTC is just lit up. Now you have a maximum authorized speed on the top and your actual speed down below. The first test that we're simulating is coming up right away. We basically have a grade crossing just after the bridge. We're simulating that the equipment is out of service, and we normally have procedures to deal with this, but now we can enforce it. The engineer is attempting to violate that situation with the grade crossing and going well above the maximum authorized speed. And now you can see that a penalty brake application was applied, and we were shut off and stopped well in advance of the grade crossing. So you can see that the grade crossing up ahead, we had to stop. And now typically the crew would get out and flag it, but this ensures that the crew will get out and flag the grade crossing that has defective equipment. Our next test is a signal that's around the corner. It's at red. It's critically important that you stop at a red signal. What we're going to simulate is trying to not stop at that signal. You can see the maximum authorized speed is 16. The engineer's ahead of that, above that. You're hearing noise that there are alerts. We continue to stay above the speed that's allowed. The computer system is calculating everything, determines that the engineer could not stop in time unless we have immediately applied an emergency brake application. So that's what happened. The train stopped well in advance of the signal, and that's a very successful outcome. And now this button needs to be actually pressed to allow the train to proceed through the interlocking, or the where crossovers are simulated. And in this situation, we actually have to stay below 15 miles an hour now to be able to get through there. And that emergency brake application is very much the sense of, like, if you do a hard brake in a car and you have anti-lock brakes.
SEPTA is positioned to meet the deadline, barring unforeseen technical and training issues or problems. And all in, we will spend $328 million achieving positive train control for our customers.